Now, returning to the US election now, Kamala Harris may have reached a new level of cringe over the weekend with this surprise appearance on Saturday Night Live, where she urged the US to keep Kamala ahead of voting day.
Like Legally Blondela.
And start decorating for Christmas. Fa-la-la-la-la. Because what do we always say? Keep Kamala and carry on-a-la.
Oh, God. Sky News contributor Kosha Gada joins me now. Kosha, does this cheese work with Americans? And what about also the claims that this might have breached the FCC, that's the Federal Communications Commission, equal time rule?
Yes, it's kind of, for Team Trump, I think, the gift that keeps giving, because there's all those angles to it. I don't think the cheese works. You know, if it's done in good dosages where the person is a serious candidate and is taken very seriously and then kind of lets loose in these formats and does a little bit of comedy on SNL, it could work, and it has worked in the past. But in her case, her biggest problem that she's been struggling with, or one of them, is she's not taken seriously as somebody who really has a handle on issues or has strong positions substantively anyway. And then when you keep leaning into sort of the comedy and the style piece of it, when there isn't substance backing it up, I don't think it actually works as a campaign matter for her. And then the second point is, it did land NBC in hot water, as you mentioned, because they're one of the four free-to-air broadcast networks in the U.S., and there are FCC rules that say if you give time to one candidate so close to the election, you have to give it to the other. And I think there was some breaking news that they are going to be forced to give 90 seconds to Team Trump to run an ad in the middle of Sunday Night Football, which may have just happened, or maybe it's Monday Night Football. He's going to be doing that to equate that so that they get out of the hot, wet water that they put themselves in.